وحقوق الوالدين. And also another major sin is disobedience to the parents. Disobedience to the parents. And Allah Azza wa Jal, interestingly enough, He actually paired the disobedience to your parents with shirk in an ayah. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this ayah, He says, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. I know a lot of people have heard this, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed that you worship none but Allah Azza wa Jalla. And right after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ, and with your parents, you do nothing but ihsan, utmost good. Similarly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala paired up the other major sin that's mentioned in this verse with shirk as well in another verse. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَاجْتَنِبُوا الرِّجْسَ مِنَ الْأَوْثَانِ وَاجْتَنِبُوا قَوْلَ الزُّورِ. Now I know a lot of people have heard the first one, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala paired it up with shirk, as in disobedience to your parents. But this one here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also paired up saying or saying a false testimony with shirk in another verse. He says, فَاجْتَنِبُوا الرِّجْسَ مِنَ الْأَوْثَانِ. So stay away from the uncleanness of the idols. And then he says, وَاجْتَنِبُوا قَوْلَ الزُّورِ. And also stay away from a false testimony. So just as the Prophet ﷺ paired up these sins in this hadith, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also paired these sins up with shirk in the ayat of Al-Qur'an. Also, that he may show to you, the Prophet ﷺ and Allah alike in this matter, they may show to you the gravity or the severe, that severe punishment that is behind these two sins. And in terms of disobedience to your parents, you know, this is definitely a grave sin. And especially to a mother. A mother that bore you. A mother that clothed you. At night time as you slept, and for those that are parents now, they realize, and then they think back and they look at, you know, their times with their parents and they regret. That had I done this, had I not done this, and then they eventually, the parents die and then you can't do anything about it. You know, so those that have parents, take advantage of it. Take advantage of it. A mother that clothed you. She fed you at night time. She bathed you. She, you know, stayed up the night. A lot of nights for a lot of mothers, they have to stay up. You know, along with that, she was ready to pick fights for your sake. Take heed for your sake. Take problems, sorry, for your sake. All of these things she did for you, and then now that we grow up, all she does is just sits and waits for you, and we don't end up what? We don't end up extending that hand to welcome our parents, welcome our mothers. And that's why the Prophet ﷺ, he said again and again, he said, رَغِمَ أَنْفْ رَغِمَ أَنْفْ رَغِمَ أَنْفْ, that may the nose of this individual be, you know, dragged into the dust, into the dirt of the ground. Once, twice, three times. He said this, and then he said, a person that met his parents, or one of them, and then they never entered him into Jannah. And because of them, he never ended up going to Jannah. And that's why Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu used to say, I don't know of any good deed that's more closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than what? Than being dutiful to the mother. For the fathers, they're like, subhanAllah, what about us? No, there is for you as well, for the fathers as well. But the reality of the matter is that the mothers have done more. That is the reality of the matter. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knew that that would be the case, and that's why He divided it up in the same manner. And that's why when the Prophet ﷺ, he was asked, مَنْ أَحَقُّ النَّاسِ بِحُسْنِ صَحَابَتِي أَوْ صُحْبَتِي يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Who is the most worthy person for me to give good companionship to? The Prophet ﷺ replied, he said, أُمُّكَ ثُمَّ مَنْ قال أمك، ثم من؟ قال أمك، ثم من؟ قال أبوك. He said, your mother, then your mother. Then he asked him again. He said, then your mother, and three times your mother, and then he said, then your father. Because of all that she has done for you. Look at the man that came to the Prophet ﷺ, and now this is for both the mother and the father. Look at the man that came to the Prophet ﷺ asking him to go for jihad. We know to go for jihad, a person has to have permission from the parents. So without a permission from the parents, a person is not permitted to go for jihad. So a man came to the Prophet ﷺ asking him this. So the Prophet ﷺ, he said, أَحَيٌّ وَالِدَكْ. Are your parents alive? Are your parents alive? So when the man said, yes, affirmative, my parents are alive, he goes, فَفِيهِمَا فَجَاهِدْ. Then therein you should struggle. Between them two is your struggle. Go and occupy your time with your parents and take advantage. Take advantage of that. And you know, if you just look at the stories of the Salaf about how they used to be to their parents, a man would stay up the entire night standing by the legs of the mother. A man would do this. Another man would walk in from Sufyan ibn Uyayna rahmatullah alayhi. He mentioned a man walked in from a travel. He saw the mother praying, and he just stood there. Because she was praying and she was standing, he didn't want to sit down out of disrespect for his mother. So he stood and stood and stood and stood until what? Until the mother finished praying. And the mother realized, subhanAllah, these are the pious people. The mother realized why he's standing up. And she realized that he'll be rewarded for this. So the mother said, you know what, I'll do the same. I'll increase in reward. So she started praying longer. So that he may get more reward. And she knew from her son that this son is not going to sit down until I finish praying. So she prayed longer and longer so that the son could, subhanAllah, so the son could get more reward. A man by the name of Al-Fadl al-Burmuki, rahmatullah alayh, he used to be extremely dutiful to his father. Extremely dutiful to his father. One of the most, you know, think about Think about a man that clothed you, as in monetarily. A man that fed you, as in he brought the food home. Probably fed as well. A man that looked out for you, your education. A lot of us are products of our fathers today. If it wasn't for the sacrifices that our fathers have made, there's definitely we wouldn't have been able to, a lot of us wouldn't have been able to reach where we reach, right? So this man, Al-Fadl al-Burmuki, rahmatullah alayh, he was with his father, and he knew that his father dislikes what? His father dislikes cold water. He doesn't like taking a shower in cold water. And he used to be really, really dutiful to his father. So one day, for whatever reason, they got imprisoned together in one prison. And they had a pot full of water. And the pot that was full of water, it was extremely cold. Because, you know, they were in prison, maybe for whatever reason, it might have been winter. It was cold. And he knew that his father doesn't like taking a shower in cold water. What do you think he did? It was a pot made of brass. He put it to his belly. And he would take the pot and have it constantly attached to his belly so his body heat would warm up the water for his father. And then when he would feel that even a little bit it's gotten warmer, then he would bring it out to his father and, you know, give it to him so that he could take a shower.